Morning, YouTubers. In today's video, I got a viewer request, so I will put his request up now. You can see what he's looking for. So I'm going to do a two-part video to answer his question, and I was kind of planning on doing something like this anyways, so it kind of worked out good for me. I'm going to primarily focus on square tube, flat plate, and a couple round pieces in this video. The next video I'm gonna be doing like saddle cuts where pipes overlap on one another, interface really nice, and then weld that. But the setup I got, this is all 1/16 inch thick square tube. Already prepped, cleaned the pieces. I got 1/16 thick plate. I got 1/16 thick tube. This is probably like 2 inch. Little bit bigger than he was looking, but for the purpose of what we're learning, this will work. I'm also going to weld some little tubes onto this as well, just to show that can be done too. So let's get into it. So the first thing we're going to be focusing on, and I'll get this stuff out of the way. We're going to be focusing on square tubing. Now this stuff, and I don't even know if it's qualified as tube, but we'll call it square tube. This is pretty common, like all your local, like Home Depot, Menards, Farm and Fleet, if you have them. They all sell this stuff, very common product. And you can make a lot of stuff with this. Like you could make maybe a bicycle rack or a rack for the back of your pickup truck. Any number of things you can use this stuff for. So pretty handy. I would definitely recommend going to a steel supplier to buy this if you need any kind of quantity, because buying it at the local box stores is probably twice as much as what it would cost you from a steel supply. Just something to think of. So anyways, we're going to be using flux core wire with this, which flux core wire is an ideal process to use on this, being that it's pretty thin. It's actually pretty easy to weld this stuff. Like if you can run welds on flat plate like this over here really good, this is going to be no issue whatsoever for you to do decent welds on. Versus the videos I've shot where I stick welded this, stick is a lot harder to get decent welds on this kind of stuff without blowing a hole. Like flux core, no problem. So the first joint I'm going to do, I'm just going to do a T setup here, which is basically going to have the equivalent of a butt joint on this side and the opposite, and then a fillet weld. So we're going to be doing both butt welds and fillet welds. What you're going to notice is, and I'm going to try and keep the settings the same for all sides, it's going to run a lot hotter on the top because there's a little bit of a gap in there due to the round corner of this. So it's going to be a little harder not to blow a hole on this than it is going and welding the fillet weld part of it. So let me go get the welder fired up and then we will start on this. All right, so I got this clamp together. I would recommend any way you can find a clamp, something like this, do it. If you have to use magnetic 90 degree corner holders, so be it. But you don't wanna have any gap that is unnecessary, because it's gonna be very difficult not to blow a hole. So the machine setting on this titanium 125 is C4, which is the low end of the recommended settings inside the machine for 16th inch. I'm going to start by doing the lap weld essentially on the top, and then I'm going to flip it, do the lap weld. I'm going to let it cool a little bit, then I'm going to do both fillet welds. All right, let's take a look at this. Get that to focus a little better for you guys. There you go. So overall, that looks really good. I mean, for just first time out of the box doing this, not bad. I noticed, so a couple things. One, definitely break off the wire or cut the wire off and start out without that ball on the end of the wire after your weld. I restarted without doing that on one of these and immediately regretted it. It kind of just popped and didn't want to start. The other thing is I noticed as I approached the corners, it started to get almost too hot. Yeah, you can see a piece of that wire. That was that start that I had that just didn't, I think that was it, that didn't weld too well. But overall, very serviceable, a lot easier than stick welding. Those little 1/16th rods I used in that other video, a lot harder. And I'll be honest, I mean, I'm not the best at stick welding sheet metal, but I don't know that that's something that you really need to or want to be good at, especially when you can use this welder and it's so much easier. Like, I'm not into doing things harder just for the sake of harder. Like, I don't see any point in that. But yeah, I mean, this is looking very good. I would say the settings are in a ballpark of where they need to be. I don't think they need to be run any hotter. So what I'll do now, since this is going better than I expected already, I will do another test weld. And this time, rather than repositioning this like I did, I'm just going to weld it. I'll weld the fillet welds vertical up, same settings, and we'll see if I can do it and not blow a hole. All right, let's take a look. Had a little bit of an oopsie there, blew the hole in the top of it. This piece was offset a little bit too much from this, and essentially once it melted through, it just blew a hole. So we'll actually go and fix that. But you can see the vertical ups. Get that focus for you. Really not that bad. This where it was much flatter and didn't have that gap in there much better. And then this one also blew a hole simply running a little too hot. So what I'm gonna do, the trick is, if you wanna fill this hole, so you got a couple problems going on. One, you have slag flux inside of there. So you wanna clean that out as good as you can get it. Otherwise, if you just weld on top of that, you're gonna have issues. The other issue is this tube or square tube has like oil inside of it. I don't think this stuff was drawn over a mandrel. It might be hard for you to see, but if you saw smoke coming from inside the tube, that's oil in there. When you have oil contaminated inside of the pipe and you're welding on it, that's going to react with your weld pool and oftentimes blow out corners and stuff. It just reacts with it. So this is kind of pretty difficult to clean the inside. Had I spent more time and actually acetone wiped the inside of this, it probably would have helped quite a bit. But this is a situation we have, so we're gonna actually fix it. So what I'm probably gonna do here is take a grinder just a little bit and touch this area up just a little bit. And we're gonna weld over this and then essentially sort of stack some tacks. I don't like stacking tacks, I'd rather run a continuous bead, but to fill this and make it look halfway decent, we're definitely gonna have to stack some tacks in there. I set the machine for like B and 3/4 and C and 3/4 roughly, or excuse me, B and 3/4 and about 3.5. We're gonna try that. So we lowered our values just a little bit, and that's hopefully gonna prevent us from blowing a hole. So now this piece, I couldn't really clean much in there. If I had a little burr on a Dremel tool, I could clean it. Really, I don't think necessary. What I'm gonna do is just fill this in. Let me take the vice grip off of there. I'm gonna fill this in probably in 2 or 3 parts. All right, so this is our repair on that. Not the prettiest. The hole is plugged, you can see. Could have ran a little bit more heat to get that to wet in there. If you were to go back with a cutoff disc or a grinder disc on a grinder, you could smooth that right out, make it look better. All right, let's take a look here. So you can see, had to go a little bit wider to patch that out. And then I wrapped the corner there because it was a little bit blown out. But overall, not a too bad of a repair. Again, you can sit and grind this off flush if you wanted, or just leave it. If you're using flux core wire, you're probably not too concerned about the overall bead appearance, to be honest with you. Again, this is just fixing what we got. So now that the machine is turned down a little bit, we're gonna try and run another test weld with it, and I bet it'll look a little bit better. I think we're right on the verge of running too hot with it. All right, let's take a look where we're at. Bump the camera again. So if you look there, overall, not too bad. You can tell it's a little bit more humped up than before, but that's okay. I mean, this is pretty thin tube. The vertical up seemed to weld really good at a slightly reduced settings, which it's gonna run hotter. And then this side, not the greatest, and then that's looking pretty good as well. So yeah, not looking too bad. Definitely serviceable for this stuff. With a little bit more practice, I could definitely nail these out to where they're looking real good. But that's about what's to be expected on this. If you were to sit and grind this a little bit, make it flush, it would improve the looks of it a little bit too, so you have that option. Let's move on to welding some of these. So very much like welding that T over there, this is very similar. The only difference is, well, it's a continuous. So being small bore like this, this is only maybe, I don't know, an inch in diameter. You're gonna have to change your gun angle with the wire a lot because you wanna have a drag angle. With MIG, you can run a push angle, which will help you on something like this. With flux core, you want to try and avoid pushing, which ends up leaving you in a situation where you almost have to move your gun like really fast in comparison. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tack it on these outer edges here, and then I'm going to show you a couple ways to set up for that. All right, if you can weld this standing upright, that will help you significantly. And if you obviously can reposition it like what I have here, even better. Most of the time, you're not gonna have that luxury. You'll probably end up welding it in position like this, where you have to weld vertical up, okay? It's gonna take less heat to weld vertical up. You're gonna end up basically having more penetration than welding it like this. But more penetration on this thin means more likely to blow holes. So we're at reduced settings already from before. I'm gonna keep it at that, and I'm gonna weld this side as much as I can vertical up. And then this side, I'm gonna weld hopefully in one continuous motion in the flat position. So we'll start out here. Now, this little part right here, clean that off. This little part right here from doing the vertical up, I couldn't tie into there. It just simply was out of position. I couldn't get the wire down there. So what I would do there is just take a little pick, clean that slag out of there, and then I would just run a bead there. But you can see, get that position for you. That welded really good. Definitely a penetration there. There's our tack up top. Now the other side that I welded in position, not too bad either. Right here I carried too much heat and my wire angle was moved too much towards the pipe and I ended up blowing a hole through it, which I patched up quickly while it was cooling. Again, not too bad. One thing that I'll say, this Lincoln wire, this is 030 wire, seems to be pretty good with the spatter. You look at this, there really isn't much of any on here. Pretty clean. I didn't mention as well, as I notice that molten pool seeming to get too hot, I'll start stepping forward a little bit and then coming back, stepping forward, coming back. The reason I'm doing that is because when you step forward a little bit, that gives the molten metal behind where you were welding chance to solidify. And then when you come back, you're almost depositing metal essentially on solid metal. Sometimes on thin wall like this, when you just keep a steady drag angle and just slowly at one speed drag it, you're gonna run into an issue where you're gonna start melting through. Just a little oscillation forward and then back can really help get that steel to solidify to where the heat is out of it so you don't blow through it. That really helped. Just for the sake of practice, I will fill this hole in here. As should you, anytime you're doing even practice, you should go back and fix your screw-ups. Yeah, there's no question. I mean, there's almost melt through. There's a little bit in places inside that tube. Probably hard for you to see, but that's looking real good. That's going to be a strong joint. So let's go and weld this one. Same deal as before. Just get a little bit more practice here. All right, so second attempt, I blew a hole down in here. I actually find that it's easier to weld vertical up than it is in a flat position. Now, part of that could be I had my wire a little bit too much focused on this and I should have had it more down here. This will hold more heat than this tube will, even though they're roughly the same thickness, just because of how this is configured. But anyways, you look at it here. I patched a hole there, again, not the best, but overall, let's see, that's looking real good. I got some flux left in there. I could have cleaned out, difficult to get in there, but that's gonna look pretty much like this, real nice looking weld. So yeah, a little bit more settings tweak, a little bit more practice. I mean, I can make these look real good, as can you. It's really not that hard. This is just 1/16 material. This welder will go lower than this, but the thinner you go, the harder it's gonna be to really control it. So let's do something a little bit different. Now, the second part of this video, I'm gonna be doing more or less tube on tube and maybe some tube to some square stuff, kind of like what I did over there. But I'm gonna take this, which is 2-inch diameter. This is just exhaust pipe. I cleaned off as much of the zinc coating as I could, And this is just the same thickness, so 1/16 or 16 gauge steel. I'm just gonna place this on here. I'm gonna tack it and then I'm gonna weld it out. So this would be common, like if you had a plate and maybe you're building, I don't know, a bumper or something, you wouldn't necessarily be using this in a material, but same kind of deal. So in this case, you can weld it in a flat position. On your project, you may actually have to weld it vertical up. So what I'll do to help you guys, I'm gonna tack it at the bottom and the top, and I will weld one side in the flat position, and then I'm gonna weld one side, I'll flip it, and I'm gonna weld it on the vertical up. I think this stuff is actually a little bit thinner than 16th. I got a decent weld there, and this weld kind of was just blowing holes. There is a little bit of a gap in there. What I'm gonna do is lower the voltage a little bit and then try that. All right, let's see what we got. So this side, and I'll take this off. The flat position, not bad. Now this one, I didn't hit low enough. I stopped where the tack was, you can see that. And then right here, I whipped a little too far forward. But then once I realized what was going on and settled in, still some flux on there. Let me clean it off so you can see better. All right. Once I settled down, overall welded pretty good. Blew a hole over here. I had to patch real quick a little bit. Again, this being zinc coated on the inside, this is actually thinner than 16th. Pretty difficult to do this. But again, very doable. The biggest detriment to trying to do thin wall like this is that there is a couple places, because this was just sawzall cut, that there is a little gap. The tighter you can get this to fit against this plate, the better off you are. Because if it's not tight, it's just gonna, it'll weld normally, and then as soon as you hit that wider space, it's just gonna act like it's welding with 20 more amps and blow a hole. So what I'll do, I'm gonna brush this and then just finish welding that because I missed it. Blended that in real nice. Oh, and I missed that there. Let's weld that up. Not looking too bad. All right, let's wrap this video up. I guess, what did we learn today? Well, I learned a lot of stuff. One, that Flux Core Wire 030, this is Lincoln's NR211, by the way, much, much easier to weld on thin material like this than stick. I mean, if I was down to just a stick welder, I would make it happen, but man, like this doesn't even take hardly any effort to get halfway decent looking welds. Like the stick welding is just not really meant for this. You can do it, but this is definitely a much better process. But yeah, I mean, the overall results are pretty acceptable. Minimal spatter. Some of the welds turned out really good. Some could use a little bit of work, but I don't do a whole lot of this. So obviously if you do this all day or a lot, you're gonna get a lot better results. But that isn't the purpose of this video. I'm not here to just sit down and lay down perfect welds and then leave a video at that, because what does that really teach you? Not a whole lot of anything, I guess. And honestly, if I wanted a perfect weld on these, I'd be TIG welding it. Even this turned out pretty good for Flux Core. Always, again, room for improvement. This pipe here, which is a little thinner than I thought it was, even that welded pretty decent onto this 1/16 plate. More than acceptable. I had to use reduced settings on that to get a decent bead. The other thing I found kind of interesting is welding vertical up. Like when you look at this little nice tight weld, I kind of suspected that running vertical up would end up blowing holes easier. Now part of it is it's going to take more heat in this position than flat because of that gap in there I talked about earlier. But vertical up produced a very narrow weld. I really like the appearance of that overall. So welding this out of position, like look at this guy. I mean, that's barely one step above or below a TIG weld, honestly. So I guess I wouldn't be afraid of running vertical up at all, really. Because with the same settings as over here, it welded really good. So don't be afraid to run out of position. I mean, Flux Core is known to weld decent out of position, and you can definitely do it. Unlike, say, short arc MIG, where when you run that vertical up, you run into a lot of issues, especially on thicker plate. You got to manipulate the puddle in order to keep it from dripping down. This stuff, this Flux Core wire, welds vertical up a lot easier. So don't be afraid of it. Trust me, I could do it. You can do it. Other than that, my part two video I'll be getting shot and put up pretty soon. That I will be doing mainly just tube to give you like saddle cut fits and stuff. It's gonna weld honestly very much like this, just round. So like a smaller version of this guy right here is kind of how it's gonna weld. But that's gonna be the hardest thing, you know, welding thin wall and then welding in position where you're welding essentially overhead, uphill, and then flat lap welds. You have all the welds in one type or one joint. Well, you're gonna have to be pretty good because it's not like TIG where you can increase or decrease amperage based on what you're seeing. So either you're gonna have to weld it in stages and adjust the welder, or you're gonna have to learn to manipulate the puddle a little bit and use the fact that this fast freezes as a help to move forward, stack metal, move forward, let it cool, move forward, come back, and that'll really help you. I mean, that's a lifesaver the way that Flux Core wire works for doing that. Like MIG and say 7018 rod isn't really known for that, so trying to manipulate your puddle to stack metal is very, very difficult, but this process isn't. So anyways, thanks for watching. Hopefully this helped you, and I'm sure the next video will help you as well. Thanks.